Hey, what's up guys? My name is Faraz and welcome to my channel, Better English Clapping Go. If you're new to my channel, please go ahead and do subscribe, guys. This course is benefiting me a lot. You can watch my videos and you can see the difference. Do subscribe my channel and keep improving and keep speaking in English confidently. Thank you.
I would release my hands and simultaneously I will release my legs as well. So there was a garden, okay, and I did not
wide open.
I did not do that on that scooty, but yeah, I am going to tell you what rajma chawal is, and I can leave tandoori chicken in front of that. I'm glad that I was able to make you laugh. Take out his sword and used to say this. I have the power. So yeah, so all these memories.
Hello.
Hey Kanika. Hello.
Hi. No.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so I'll be your speaker for the day.
Okay.
And topic is childhood, right?
Childhood, okay.
Okay, so tell me something about your childhood.
Okay. So, yeah. So,
when you were a child.
I'm so sorry. I wasn't able to hear it. Could you repeat that?
Yeah, sure. I said, share your favorite memory when you were a child. Anything, you know.
Okay.
It can be funny, it can be
recall. There will be many. Let me try to recall one of those memories. Let me first try to recall that memory, then I'll be able to talk about that memory. Yeah, so one of the memories that I'll like to share that I'm able to recall now is when I started try learning bicycle. That was the first time. Like one of those funny incidents when everyone experience, like when everyone goes through it. So I also had gone through the same thing. So what I used to do, you know, whenever, so my elder brother taught me how to ride a bicycle. Okay. And so whenever you learn how to ride a bicycle, so the very first thing, the very first step would be that the person who is teaching you how to ride a bicycle. So you are sitting on the bicycle and the person who is behind you, who is actually pushing you and taking care of you and the bicycle too. So he would push me, okay? And what I will do, I will of course, like I will ride, and if I see anything coming in front of me, then what I would do, I would release my hands and simultaneously I will release my legs as well. So there was a garden, okay, and I totally banged there my bicycle. So that was one of the funniest incidents. So of course we would never know, because at that kind of age we wouldn't know that what exactly we are doing. So this was the one of the funniest incidents that how I started learning the bicycle. And and same happened. Like there is a similar incident which had happened with me when the very first time when I had ridden the my father's scooty. Okay, so I did not
wide open.
I did not do that on that scooty, but yeah, I am going to tell you what had happened. So like I was riding like a pro. Like, still, I was a child at that point in time because I knew how to ride the bicycle. And if you know how to ride the bicycle, you would be able to ride the bike if it is an automatic bike, you know, because you would know how to balance it.
Yeah.
So that was the first time what I did. So I did not tell my father that I'm taking the bike out. Okay, taking the scooty out. So I guess he must be sleeping. So what I did, I took out the key, and I had taken out the scooty. So I was riding like a pro. Like, there was straight line. It was all fine till then. But when I had to take the right turn, I had taken the right turn, and I had taken that turn so swiftly, so I fell down. Yeah, so that was the another incident that I remember. But yeah, these are such memories that they don't skip out your minds.
Okay. Can you tell me your favorite game as a child? Something you really enjoyed to play?
Yeah. So I really used to play. Like, I really used to like. Still, I like playing badminton. So now I don't play badminton. But in my childhood, I used to play it a lot. Yeah, more than cricket.
Oh. That's
yeah.
Good.
And I really love playing table tennis, which I had learned in my office. So when I had started working with Converges, so learned there table tennis. I had like learned there, and before that, I really used to like playing badminton. So yeah, so and I was good at it. So yeah, and
okay. Yeah. Your favorite food as a child.
Food as a child. Okay, still my food remains the same, which still I like the most. That, like, I am a hardcore non-vegetarian, yeah, but I love rajma chawal, and that is my favorite dish when mom cooks it. I cannot have it anywhere else. Yeah, so rajma chawal, yeah, and I can leave tandoori chicken in, like, in front of that. That is the most favorite dish of mine. Mom cooked rajma chawal. Yeah,
that's absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
So, did you watch television or shows or movies when you were a child, or any favorite movie shows, or you know?
Yes. I am a movie-holic. So, like, in the last couple of months, I had not been watching movies or series. But since my childhood, I had been watching movies. Because, like, I am a movie-holic, I can say.
Can you
bring some of your favorite? Yeah. Kanika, your sound is going on and off. I'm not able to hear you properly. Like, there is a stagnant in your voice.
Okay. Am I audible now?
Like, the video is not as smooth as it should be. Yeah. Fine. Yeah. It is getting stuck in between. Now it is frozen.
Is it fine now?
Better. Yeah.
Okay. So, you had any favorite shows that you would want to watch? You know, leaving everything aside, like, I want to watch this. I don't care. Whatever work I have. And something that good, something you really enjoyed watching.
So nowadays, I have been watching this series Young Sheldon. I really found it good. Like I really find it good. Yeah. So it is like it is good. Like it is about Sheldon, and he is young. He's very intelligent, and he's been promoted in his class. So right now he's only 10 or 11 maybe, but like he has been promoted to college due to his intelligence. So how he copes with everything. So he's actually very finicky with like whenever there is this cleanliness thing comes. So he has this particular food chart which he follows. So and his mom is very protective for him because so
being protective, were your parents protective when you were a child? Were they very strict?
They were never been very strict. Never. Both. Like they had always given me freedom. They have always asked me like whatever you want to do, just do it. So they have never really forced me even to study as well. So what I had been like in my childhood. So I have never been so what I should say. How should I put it? Like I have never. So I have been hardworking, but the kind of behavior which I carry is that, let's say if I have an exam that tomorrow that would be of 10 marks, okay, and I would study for 6-7 marks for the passing marks, and I'll ask my mom, okay, it is done, so I'll be able to pass. Okay. So I will not study for complete 10 marks. So I'll just do the required study. So I'll just get the passing marks. So this behavior I had been since my childhood.
So can you tell me about the things you believed when you were a child? And when you think about them, you start laughing. Something that does not really exist. For example, Santa Claus, fairies, or you know, Superman, or something like that. You ever believed that they exist? But then later on, as you grew up, you got to know they're not real, and something like that.
Yeah, because I used to watch so many cartoon shows and these. Supernatural stories, fairy tales I used to watch, and but like I like in my childhood too I knew that like these are like this is actually fiction, so I would say so somehow I knew, but what I would say that at that point in time that I used to believe or I always wanted to have some kind of supernatural power because I always wanted to fly because I was a great superhuman Superman fan, so I really used to you know collect his pictures, small pictures, and Or for that matter, not only his pictures, for other, I was a great He-Man fan as well. So when he used to, you know, take out his sword and used to say this, I have the power. So, all these memories. So, I used to feel like I should have one of those powers in me. So, I'll do this, I'll do that. Because childhood is the best period, as I believe, because you don't tend to carry any kind of tension or you're just free. Okay. And I still believe as you cross your 30, then so if I talk about my childhood, so it happens with everyone, you know, when I used to come back from school. Had I used to be so thin, still I had so much energy. I didn't used to it, and you know, just I used to throw away my bag and used to go for to play cricket in the ground, or for that matter, to play or any other game it can be. So yeah, so at that like in that periods had so much energy, so they had. Yeah, please go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah, but we don't have a lot of time left.
Yeah. I would want to know your feedback as well. Yeah, please do.
You're good at forming sentences, and I had a lot more questions to ask you, but I think you really enjoyed answering them and you went in detail. That is absolutely great, because you used the language properly. You formed proper sentences. And there's just some issue while you stammer, or when you're trying to form a sentence,
you repeat
a word. Yeah, like that is okay. That can be worked over time. Other than that, you were great according to me, you know.
Thank you.
You can communicate very nicely, I can say. And obviously, after asking you questions, you continuously, you know, giving out your experiences was really good. And I enjoyed. I laughed as well.
Really, me. Thank you so much. I'm glad that I was able to make you laugh. And surely, I'm looking forward for our next conversation. Yeah.
Oh, it was also nice, you know, talking to you. So, do you want to ask anything, or do you want some more questions that I?
For me? Please, if you could just elaborate it further. Yeah, like in any way. Yeah, just the feedback, like whatever you want to say. Yeah.
Well, I'll say you keep doing whatever you are, that is watching movies, right? English movies?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Okay, that is great, especially with subtitles, because you also get to know about the word, the meaning, and where it is used in a sentence. I would also say try to practice it more, like you did it with me. Try to do it with your family members, your colleagues, your mates, and that's it for now. And try reading novels or books. Other than that, you are fine. Definitely.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay.
All right. I guess,
I'm not sure when it's going to stop, but then.
Yeah.
Do you have any siblings?
Yes, I have an elder brother.
So you enjoyed playing with him during your childhood?
Yeah.
You guys all the time.
So like we have an age gap for six, like he is 6 years elder than me. Mm-hmm. So yeah, like he's been guiding me in everything. And like he is working as an automotive journalist. So I generally speak to him in English. So that also helps me a lot. And he speaks very good. He had worked as a content writer as well. And he has a very good command over the language. So yeah, that also benefited me a lot. And I'm an English honors graduate, so I keep reading novels. Yeah. So have been trying to improve.
Did you, join this particular platform? Was there a particular reason? Was there a reason for you to join?
Because I want to be more fluent, I wanted to assess myself that where exactly I stand, and that I have been getting, of course, good feedbacks, and actually these kind of feedbacks they motivate you. And one of the major reasons is that why I had opted for it is to keep practicing and to remain in the flow. As I have been working, and of course there is always scope for everyone.